Hello everyone, thanks for joining this Salesforce CPQ program. Here this side Amul Barnwal. In today's topic I am going to discuss about how to use the quote calculator plugin in the Salesforce CPQ platform, and I would take one example here how this Salesforce CPQ quote calculator plugin is helping in overriding the quote quantity or overriding the partner discount, or whether you can use the external object to get the exact discounting from custom object and get populated on a quote line level. So here I would take one simple example where you can see I am going to show you the next slide here. In this particular slide you see I have my product A, B and C. My product C quantity will be the product A and B. So product A plus product B quantity will be my product C quantity actually. So this work you can also achieve with help of a price rule, where you can use a summary variable. With help of this summary variable you can again achieve this particular task or this particular use case scenario. But I would like to highlight here is this particular scenario I am going to achieve through with help of a quote calculator plugin. So for this quote calculator plugin, before we move to our exercise how we can achieve, I would like to navigate to the Salesforce CPQ model, and I have already added this particular product A, B and C, and I am changing the quantity of product A as well as changing the quantity of product B, and click on a calculate button. The moment you will calculate, our quote calculator plugin will be executed and it will automatically change the quantity of the product C, which is based on product A quantity plus product B quantity. This part that we have achieved with help of again a quote calculator plugin. Quote calculator plugins provides both JavaScript based and Apex class based. So here you must have a good hands on Apex logic as well as the JavaScript programming logic actually. So once you have a good programming logic, then you would be able to achieve this kind of like a use case or use scenario in your Salesforce CPQ program. I am moving to the setup how we have achieved this one actually. So I would like to share this particular example that I took and how I have achieved here. So in this quote calculator plugin, I have implemented a SBQQ quote calculator plugin as a interface here. So these two interfaces that they provided call quote calculator plugin and plugin 2 actually. So I have implemented this interface in our a global class name called QCP for finding lookup records or for overriding a quantity actually. So you can just rename this Apex class based on your need, and then on my after calculate logic. So this is my method for on after calculate logic, which is passing this quote and lines actually. So I am getting all my lines data information, and based on these lines data information I am getting the I am calculating the sum of all my product A and product B quantity, and then I am reiterating the same lines to in order to override the sum of the quantity. So sum of quantity is nothing but it's a product A and product B quantity that I am summing out under the variable call sum of quantity, and the same sum of quantity I'm going to initialize on a product C quantity actually here. So this particular code you can also get this detail, or this particular PPT will be shared to you on a YouTube link also, where you can download and you can have a similar kind of exercise in your org. So and after like implementing or after creating this particular Apex class, the another step that you have to do is go to the install package of the Salesforce CPQ, click on a configure, then go to the tab name called plugins, and here you will have to provide the Apex class name if you are using the Apex class for the quote calculator plugin. So they also provide like a legacy quote calculator plugin and quote calculator plugin. So this one is for JavaScript. If you are writing a JavaScript code, if you are writing a Apex class, then you will have to provide this Apex class, whatever that you have created so far. So with help of this particular code calculator plugin, you are able to even override the quantity or override the price or override the discount. And you can also have an external object where you can query those external object based on your criteria, based on your code criteria. Then you can pick up this exact discount and populate on a quote line page itself. So this is all about your code calculator plugin, how we can achieve quickly this particular customization with help of code calculator Apex logic programming actually. So that's it for today's session, guys. Thanks for liking, thanks for subscribing this particular code CPQ platform, and thanks for sharing to the YouTube channel, to your network, like LinkedIn. Please do share this subscription to all your friends, colleagues, whosoever is working on a Salesforce CPQ program. Thanks. Thank you, guys.